John White. Today we're taking some letters from the mailbag, and the first is from Ruth at Deming, and she asked why her tomato plant is dying from the bottom up, developing a lot of brown leaves on it, and some of her leaves up on the top are also beginning to discolor. And what you might have is very much similar to what we see on this tomato in front of me. These may be the outward signs of one of the wilt diseases starting to hit, and that can be either fusarium or verticillium wilt. They're a soil-borne fungus, so they're in the soil. Once the plant has contracted the disease, there's not much you can do about it. The plant can be pulled up, or you can let it go ahead and try and finish off. But remember, you do have the disease in the soil. If you want to send a sample in for diagnostic purposes to make sure which one of the diseases you do have, you can do that. But it is important to know that you do have the disease in the soil, and replanting tomatoes again in the same spot, you're still going to run across probably the same problems. Unfortunately, there's not a real good chemical treatment for gardeners. Probably the best thing is to use what we call as a soil solarization. That's where you cover the garden area or the rows that are affected with a clear plastic, about a 4 to 6 mil plastic, and seal them on the edges and let the soil cook in the sunlight, and that way you'll develop the 160, 180 degrees in there that will kill that organism, and that'll help some. Rotating crops, of course, is very important. Some of the browning that you may see on, or the discoloration on the tips, like this one here, we're showing what looks like spider mite damage on some of the top parts. You can see how we're developing a little bit of a whitish cast to the leaf. You can see how the green's disappearing, it's being replaced with kind of a dusty whitish look to it, and that's spider mite on tomatoes. So we do see that this time of year, so that is a problem. A lot of times can be cured just by using plain water, hosing it down, getting the humidity built up a little bit. But again, with the wilt problems, it's much harder to control, so it may require making some strong changes in your garden plans for next year. So hopefully that's been some help. Stay with the VF varieties when you're picking your tomato varieties. That will help to avoid some of the damage, but again, like I said, they're not 100% resistant to it, so hopefully that'll help you out. Another question we had was from Bill in Las Cruces, and was asking on his tomatoes. He noticed the plant was not growing real well, was showing some signs of wilt during the day, and took the plant, pulled it up, and found that some of the roots on the bottom of the plant were enlarged and elongated. Or not elongated, but enlarged. And for Bill, if you pull up a tomato plant and you pull up some of the roots and you start to see quite a bit of enlargement on some of the roots, especially out on the ends, that can be a sign of nematode damage. A good healthy root system will grow out straight without any bumps or enlargement in it. So if you're starting to see enlargement in the roots, that can be nematode damage again. Very, very hard to control because there's not much in the way of any kind of chemical treatment that you can use for nematodes. So you want to stay with the nematode resistant varieties. Nematodes will hit a wide variety of plants, not just tomatoes, but they seem to prefer tomatoes, or they show up more on tomatoes, but you can find them on a lot of different things. Soil solarization works also. Adding organic matter to the soil will help, since the nematodes seem to like more of a sandy soil rather than a heavy soil. So again, this is a problem that you can work on for next year's crop. Another question we had was from Janice in Mesilla, and she was asking what is causing all the little tiny holes in the leaves of her eggplant. And here, what Janice probably has a problem with, is, which is real common in eggplant, is flea beetle damage. And unfortunately, I don't have any flea beetles on here to show you, but this is what the damage looks like, and it just looks like somebody kind of hit it with a shotgun. There's, you know, 100 little tiny holes that are in the leaf, and after their insect has left, you have all these little tiny holes, and they just perforate the leaf. If they get bad enough, they can gradually brown the leaf out. Leafhopper is fairly easy to kill. There are several different insecticides that can be used. You want to make sure that you do use a product that is labeled for use on eggplant. There are some organic insecticides that you can use also. A lot of times if you can find the adults there, if you can kind of catch them, just squash them off, you can take care of a lot of the problem that way. But this is flea beetle. It's a little black or dark bluish metallic colored beetle, very small, and you'll find it on the undersides or the top side of the leaf. So again, flea beetle damage on eggplant.